is 1:30.
1点半到了，各位同学。
Okay. We all need to feel better, so everybody stand up.
我们大家都需要就是运动一下，疏松一下筋骨。请各位起立，跟着老师的动作。
I'm going to teach you a song that I grew up with.
我要教大家一首我从小学到大的歌。
It's called the Hokey Pokey.
叫做 Hokey Pokey.
It goes like this. 就是我现在要示范
了。
You put your right hand in, you take your right hand out.Do your right hand in and you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. You put your left hand in, you take your left hand out.
You put your left hand in and you shake it all about.
You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.Put your right foot in, you put your right foot out. Put your right foot in, and you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey, and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. You put your right foot in, you take your right foot out. You put your left foot in, take your left foot out. And you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey, and you turn yourself around.That's what it's all about. You put your backside in,
you put your backside out.
You put your backside in, and you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey, and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. You put your whole self in, you take your whole self out. You put your whole self in, you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey, and you turn yourself around.That's what it's all about. And you feel better?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm tired. I'm going to go to bed. Try to wake us up a little.
所以让大家更清醒一点。
Do you have any questions?Anything you want to talk about?
大家有任何问题吗？还有是有什么想问的
？Good.
Okay, I ask a small group in our workplace. It's just one of few Christians in our workplace. Yeah. So, how can we start a small group?
Well, good.
Yeah.
Thank
you.
That's great. One of the things that we run into at KIBC, which is Calvin International Baptist Church, is we don't have the space. I think that's the same problem here. If you don't have space to do what you want to do on Sunday morning during Sunday school hour, you do it at other place. You do it another time in another place. And it could be anywhere. It doesn't have to be on Sunday morning at church.It can be anywhere, at any time, when you have a teacher and a group of people who want to get together. The thing you need to remember is that it needs to be, it's preferable if it's a holistic group, not a closed group. That other people are invited, that other people come, and that you do things like prayer and reach out to other people.And you have some kind of activity, hopefully. Now, I have found in holistic Bible study groups, the hardest thing to do is number 5, apply as a group the gospel that you're studying. It's hard many times to do mission action group together. But that's group. It's best if you can, but that's the hardest thing to do.
所以我们这边的问题就是，我怎么样可以在工作的场合里面开始自己的小组嘛，对不对？那个牧师的答案是说，其实在礼拜天的时候，因为我们都会有不一样的服事或是不一样的事工的忙碌，那所以呢，有一些时候我们没有办法在教会有参加小组，当然最好的状态就是我们可以在其他的时间，就是像工作的时候可以有一个小组。那这个小组最重要的元素呢，就是它有一个老师，然后有一群人，然后聚集在一起。那我们要遵守的原则呢，就是我们可以怎么样的去将这样子的一个组织变成一个全面性的、全备性的一个团体。比如说，我们要有祷告，我们要可以一起做一些活动，然后我们可以一起研读神的话语。那这些就是一个小组它的要素了，这样子。那当然，里面最难的就是第五项，就是我们怎么样可以整个小组一起来参加福音的事工。那当然，这个是很困难的，因为我们就等于是整个小组必须要成为一个团体去做这样子的一个事工。但是如果我们可以的话，这会对于小组的成长非常有帮助。
Any questions about what a leader looks at like?
那大家
we took the test.
那大家对这个小组长所需要的特质，就是我们吃饭前做的这个问卷的时候，大家对这里面的特质有没有什么问题呢？
And some of you look surprised about that test.
因为我们其中有些人在做完这个问卷的时候，脸色是非常的惊讶的。
So is there anything I need to clear up about that?
所以里面还有哪一些特质是需要牧师更多的解释的？
Being outgoing is not necessary. No, it's not. You think outgoing people. You think of people who are. Type A, what we call type A personalities, that is an outgoing personality, one who's always, you know, trying to enlist people and do those kinds of things. That's not a criteria, because there are many good leaders and good teachers who have a more introverted. Now, you will not believe this, but take a good look at me.I am an introvert.
所以刚刚的问题就是说，在组长的特质里面啊，我们看到有一点是外向。那外向到底是不是一个必须的小组长特质呢？那牧师的答案是，外向其实并不一定是个组长的特质，因为牧师本人也不是一个外向的人，他是一个内向的人，这样子。
If you gave me a choice.Of standing before this group, or going to the library to read a book, I would go to the library to read a book.
因为如果你今天问牧师说他下午有两个选择，一就是站在这里，二就是去图书馆读一本书。牧师的选择会是去图书馆读本书。所以如果外向不是一个必要的特质，你觉得当一个小组长如果他有外向的特质的话，会是比较好？
I think the most important thing is God's calling.
他觉得最重要的东西是你真的有感受到神的呼召。
Good. You see, I got a long speech on this and I don't want to get all the way into it, butAnd I'm going to teach next Sunday school class tomorrow, and we're going to talk more about this tomorrow, next Sunday school class, so if you can come to it, I'll give you a brief thing. When God calls you to do something, He gives you whatever is necessary for you to be able to do that. And He may not do it the way everybody else does it. You may not do it the way everybody else does it. But you can still be successful at it. Because the key is, are you doing what God wants you to do? And are you relying on Him to be the person that gives you the strength to do that? rather than doing it from yourself.
所以当我们在看一个小组长的时候，真的不是这个人他的个性的特质有什么，而是他领受的上帝的呼召是什么。因为当我们在做事情的时候，当我们在服侍神的时候，有一些时候神呼召给我们，神呼召我们去做的事工，他一定会加给我们足够的能力去完成这项的事工。那有一些时候上帝做事不像我们人做事的做法一样，但是上帝的旨意，只要你很清楚这是上帝的旨意，上帝就会祝福你手的事工。
For instance, my wife is a very outgoing person. She has never met a stranger. She probably has 1,200, 1,500, 2,000 friends on Facebook.
例如牧师的妻子是一个非常外向的人，她从来都没有遇过陌生人，她脸书上面的好友大概至少有1,200 to 2,000+朋友。
What she has been doing the entire time that we've had lunch is she has been WhatsApping people all over the world. And what I have been doing is sitting there going, That's why we had to do the hokey pokey to get me going.
例如我们刚刚在用午餐的时候呢，我的妻子就一直在手机上面联络她世界各地的朋友，但是呢，牧师刚刚却是利用了午餐的时间来午休一下，这是为什么我刚刚要做一点暖身运动。
So it's easier maybe for an outgoing person, but it is not necessary for them to be an outgoing person.
所以对于一个小组长来说，或许拥有外向的特质会让小组长这个工作比较轻松，但是它并不是一个身为成功小组长的必要条件。
But on the other hand, they may rely upon their own strength too much and not rely upon God's strength.
但是换句话来说，如果对一个外向的人来说，他们可能会太过度的仰赖自己的个性特质，而不去仰赖神来带领这个小组。
Become so self-confident that they don't prepare, they don't pray, they don't do the things that they need to do. Whereas the person who is not strong in those areas, they know they have to go to the Lord, they know they have to pray, they know they have to do.
或许外向的人可能太过自信，所以他们就不需要太去准备，不需要太去祷告，不需要太去关怀。但是对于一个不这么外向的人，他反而更会谦卑的到神那里去，寻求神的帮助。
But that's a good, very good question, because that needed to be clarified. See, one of the things that we tend to do in church is we tend to think.The way the world thinks. Yeah, we tend to think the way that the world thinks, and therefore a person needs to be a teacher, he needs to have a lot of knowledge up here, he has to have been to seminary or to the Bible school or all of these kinds of things, and they have to have an outgoing personality. And some of the best adult Sunday school small group leaders I know ofHave none of those.
这是一个很好的问题，因为这个问题让我们想到，常常在教会里面，我们会用世人的眼光去看服事的对象，我们会希望就是这样子的小组长，这样的带领主日学的领袖，会是一个有受过神学教育的，然后很外向的，然后充满领袖特质的人，但是往往我见过的最好的主日学的领袖都不是这样子的人，不是这样的人。
Any other questions?
其他问题吗
？Yes, ma'am.
请问一下，那个示范和鼓励布道友谊。
This so you can say that outside. Everybody can hear you.
就请问一下，就是说这边有一题，就示范和鼓励布道友谊，这个是怎么样的一个做法？谢谢。
Could you explain the modeling and encouraging friendship evangelism?
Oh yes. Evangelism The most effective evangelism is not confronting people that you do not know and just going ABC, this is the way to be saved.
最有效的传福音的方式并不是就面对一个人然后告诉他说这个就是救恩然后 A 是什么 B 是什么 C 是什么
I am not saying that that does not work
这并不是说这样子的方法没有办法传福音
And there are some people who are evangelists who have the gift of evangelism who can use that method
有一些非常有恩赐的宣教勇士，他们可以用很直接的这样子上述的方法来分享福音。
But most of us do not have the gift of evangelism.
但是我们大部分的人都没有这样子传福音的恩赐。
But because we do not have the gift, does not mean that we should not be evangelistic.
但我们没有传福音的恩赐，并不代表我们不能传福音，或是不应该去传福音。
I like to say it this way. More people are loved into the kingdom than they are convinced into the kingdom.
我常常这样子说，就是大家很多人比起就是被教导而进入神的国，更多人是因为被爱而进入神的国。
More people come to the Lord because they have a friend who is a friend to them and talks to them and brings them to church and sits down with them and calmly answers their questions and tells them this is my story rather than saying A, B, C, you know, you're a sinner, God loves you, etc., etc., and they're convinced. You can tell them that, but they're not convinced until You are modeling the loving God that we serve.
比起教导式的传福音，人们更容易因为有个基督徒的朋友，有个基督徒的朋友带他们到教会，有个基督徒的朋友愿意与他们同坐，与他们分享，与他们解答他们的问题，帮助他们。爱他们就像是模效法耶稣一样的这样子的关爱他们而让他们能够接受福音
So the most effective small group leaders are the ones who build relationships with their members and build relationships with people outside of the group and slowly but surely woo them in Is that a good Chinese word, woo?
sure. 就是woo就是哄的意思啊。那个基本上牧师的意思就是说，其实最有效的小组的方式是，就是说去，就好像我们一开始讲的一样，去建造这样子的一个关系，这样子的一个团队，这样的一个社区，能够让基督徒能够更深化他们彼此之间的关系，也可以让外面的人因为这样的方式被吸引进团队来，然后就是有点像被哄进来一样。
Does that answer your question?
姐妹，这样 OK 吗？
大概了解这样的意思，就是跟他关系建立好。然后用各样的方式帮助他来亲近神等他认识神了他就会爱神是这样的意思
是的 so he basically she just repeated that the friendship fostering is a way of evangelism
right now that, as I said you still understand our relationship with God that we're sinners and you're able to communicate that with them But you don't do it from a confrontational stance, you do it from a friendship stance, from a loving, concerned, compassionate stance.
当然就是说这样子的传福音或这样子的分享福音是用一个友善的一个充满爱的充满关怀的方式去建立一个友谊的关系而不是说是去创造一些冲突或是创造一些就是面对面的那种教条的方式
You have a relationship first, and then you present the gospel.
你要先建立一段关系，然后再分享福音。
谢谢。One back here.
哎，我想请问一下，就是他有一个问题，就是经常为非基督徒朋友祷告，这个他就是答案是就是列为不是很重要。那我们刚刚有提到，其实上一堂课有提到，主日学他也有宣教的成分在。那我想说，这个我就比较难理解。
So there's this point where praying for non-Christian friends and it is listed as non-important.And so, a brother here is, 等一下, important, right? 等一下 praying consistently for non-Christian friends matters, right?
Yes, so, it matters.
Yes. I think it's a misprint.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's actually a misprint.
It's a misprint in the Chinese. That's a misprint in the Chinese. It is very important. It's on the side. It's very important that you pray for your non-Christian friends. It's very important.That the leader of the group pray for the members of the group.
所以这个地方就是中文可能漏了一题，所以我们这个地方会有点对不起来。但是为非基督徒祷告是小组长的一个很重要的特质，而且不但是，所以我们要鼓励小组长不只是为他们的组员祷告，也要为他们非基督徒的朋友祷告。
I'm glad you asked that question because that needs to be cleared if that's a mistake in that.Translation. Yeah. I think last night we found out that one of those was left out of the Chinese. We had like, I don't forget how many listing, but ever how many of on the English side, there's one left out on the Chinese side. And I can't remember which one it was.
有一个特质，对，基本上是被忽略。哎，请说。
注意到并鼓励使用其他人的恩赐跟才能，那这个小组长要怎么样去发现他们的恩赐跟才能？然后还有包括刚刚讲神的呼召对每个人的呼召，如何把这些连结在一起？谢谢。
So the question is about the second last point, noticing and encouraging others' gifts and abilities, and also connecting that to.Earlier, what you said about God's calling,、mm-hmm. how can we confirm God's gifts, God's ability, like the God's calling or God-given abilities and gifts?
Excellent question. One of the things that we, now, how many of you have read the Bible?
我们举一下手，大家有读过圣经的，请举一下手。
Okay.Good, most of you, you know.
大部分
How many of you have taken a spiritual gift test?
如果你有做过属灵恩赐的问卷的话，请举一下手。
An inventory.
请问什么叫属灵恩赐的问卷？
What is a questionnaire for a spiritual gift?
Yeah, a questionnaire for spiritual gifts. At the end of it, it says you probably have these spiritual gifts. How many of you have taken that?
就是有一个属灵恩赐的测试，有就是个问卷，对。
How many spiritual gifts, as you read the Bible, did you see Moses took?
大家在圣经中看到摩西，你觉得摩西有多少属灵的恩赐
？Did he take a spiritual gift test?
你觉得摩西有做过那个属灵恩赐的问卷吗
？No. How about Paul?
你觉得保罗有做过属灵恩赐的问卷吗？
No? How about Peter?
你觉得彼得有做过属灵恩赐的问卷吗
？How do you think they figured out?
那你觉得这些圣经中的人物怎么样知道他们的属灵恩赐是什么
？The Holy Spirit. Huh?
圣灵吗？through practice, actual practice and exercising.
Through action.The Holy Spirit and they actually practice their spirit. Do you remember the calling of Moses?
大家还记得摩西是怎么呼召的吗
？God called him, Moses. I want you to go to Egypt, and he said, "Okay." No, no, no. Oh, he made an excuse. He says, oh, but God, I can't talk.
对，大家还记得摩西他第一次遇见神，被神呼召的时候，上帝透过那个对着火的荆棘跟他说，我希望你到埃及去。然后摩西说，我去吗？没有，他说他不讲话。
Send Aaron, he can talk.
所以摩西甚至还找借口说，你就叫我哥哥亚伦去，对，因为亚伦比较会讲话。
People of Israel aren't going to listen to me.
摩西说，以色列人也不会听我讲话啊。
All I am is a sheep herder.
所以我只是个牧羊人而已。
God does what he wants to do.
上帝按他的心意做事。
You see, if God has called you to a work,
如果神呼召你去做一个事工，
then he will gift you to do that work.
那他就会给你足够的恩赐，让你完成这个事工。
It may not look like the same way someone else would do it.
可能你做这个事工的方式不是符合其他人的预期。
One of the things that is really interesting in history, we had a great preacher in the United States called Jonathan Edwards.
所以我们有看到历史中常常一些有趣的事，其中一个就是在美国有一个非常有名的布道家叫做爱德华。
He had a sermon entitled "Sinners in the Hands of an Angry God."
他其中一个讲章的名字就是在愤怒的神的中心。
Jonathan Edwards was probably the most boring preacher you have ever heard.
爱德华牧师大概是你能够见过最无聊的牧师了。
He wrote down every word he was ever going to preach.
因为他总是会把他讲章一字一字一字的写出来。
And when he preached it, he read it.
所以而且当他讲到的时候，他是一个字一个字的读。
The story goes that he never even looked at the people he was preaching to.
他甚至不会抬头看着他的会众。
God used it because he had called him to preach.
但是上帝使用这个牧师，因为上帝呼召这个牧师来做这个事工。
And he prayed beforehand and he did all of the things that he needed to do and let God do what God could do.
因为爱德华牧师做了一切准备的工作，包括祷告，所以上帝可以使用这位牧师。
He would have never made it in today's society.
爱德华牧师在今天的社会里面可能没有办法，可能甚至不可能成名。
What we need to do is we need to be in relationship with our Father.
但是我们需要的就是我们需要跟我们的天父维持着一个关系。
And relationship with our people.
跟我们身边的弟兄姐妹维持着关系。
And we do what we can do, and when God calls us to do something, we should try it.
我们尽我们的能力，而当神的呼召临到我们的时候，我们不要害怕去尝试。
We tend to measure people by the world's standards.
我们不可以用世人的眼光、世俗的眼光去衡量一个人的能力。
And that's a mistake.
因为这是一种错误。
So, what you do is, if you feel God calling you, you start trying out those gifts.
所以我们应该做的就是，如果今天我们领受到神的呼召，我们就应该去尝试。
If you're a teacher, you start preparing.
如果神呼召你当一个教师，那你就应该开始预备。
And you pray.
那继续的祷告。
And you practice.
继续的操练。
And the results will either come or they won't come. IfYou may have made a mistake. Maybe God didn't call you to that, but you don't know until you try.
当然，我们如果不尝试，也不会知道结果。这个结果也可能是正面的，也可能是负面的，因为说不定上帝的心意并没有呼召你去当老师。
This young lady had the exact right answer. You try.
因为这位姐妹 讲到的答案就是我们必须要去经历。
Because you never know how God will bless you.
因为你不知道上帝的祝福会如何临到你。
Any other questions?
其他问题 yes.
你写多是认出在我们华人社会里面，我们很难看到人的潜力。我们常常看是人做得不够好的地方。那怎么样是可以帮助我们可以去看到有潜力的主张？
On the very last point, it talks about identifying and utilizing potential leaders. But we as Chinese, bounded by our culture, it's easier for Chinese people to look at the failures or the shortcomings of members instead of looking at their potentials. So how can we overcome that and start utilizing potentials and grow leaders?
That's a very good question. One of the things that is most difficult to do in situations like this is to overcome culture.
所以这是一个很好问题。那在这样子的情况中，其实最重要的一点就是我们要去战胜我们的文化背景。
So I think one of the things we need to do as Christians is we need to look at the New Testament. We need to look at how Jesus lived in Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, and see how he encouraged people.
所以我觉得很重要的一部分，我们怎么样可以超越我们的文化的眼光，就是我们可以看到耶稣他在福音书中他是怎么样去鼓励他的门徒们。
We as humans tend to look at other people and measure them according to our standards.
我们身为人，我们常常会用我们的眼光去衡量别人，用我们的标准去批判别人。
And it's very easy for us who have been a Christian for a while and know what's going on within the church and know the Bible and all of those kinds of things to become kind of uppity.
我们尤其是当我们成为基督徒一段时间之后，我们也知道教会在干嘛，我们也知道了一点圣经知识的时候，对我们来说，我们常常会变得就比较自豪一点。
Uppity is a good word for being arrogant.
当然自豪也就是自傲。
And we tend to look down on people who haven't made it yet.
我们常常会看低那些还没有到达这样子的标准的人。
According to our standards.
当然是我们的标准的人。
But what we need to do is we need to measure ourselves.By the standard of Jesus.
但是我们需要做的就是，我们常常要用耶稣的标准来看我们自己。
And then maybe we won't be so quite so arrogant.
那我们可能就不会这么骄傲了。
See, after we've been in church a while, we forget that all are sinners.
常常我们成为基督徒一段时间之后，我们会忘记我们都是罪人。
And one of the great sins is that we think more of ourselves than we ought to.
那其中很大的一项罪就是我们把自己看得比自己原先的还要高。
We become like Jesus' enemies in the New Testament.Who were the Pharisees?
我们就变成了像那些法利赛人，就是在新约里面敌对耶稣的那群人。
And we have certain rules and regulations that we think people ought to come up with, or reached before they can start doing things they need to do.
所以我们会自己设一些标章，自己设一些规范，然后我们觉得别人需要先去达到这一些标准。不然的话，他们不能去做其他事。
And so, we as leaders need to be aware of that. And let me say this: every one of you who is in this room is a leader.
所以，当我们成为领导的时候，我们就需要有这样的自觉。而且，我们现在坐在这边的每一位都是一个 领导者。
Oh, you may say, well, not me. I'm not a leader. I'm just here. I'm not a leader. No.
你可能会说啊，有，其实我不是个领导者，我就只是不小心坐在这里而已。
But the fact is, how do you define leadership?
但事实上是你怎么样去定义什么叫做领袖？
You define leadership very simply. Leadership is the ability to influence.
所以我的领袖特我对领袖的定义非常简单。领袖的定义就是影响力。
When you open your mouth and say something negative to somebody else, what are you doing?
当你打开嘴说了一些不好听的话给别人的时候，你做了什么？
You're influencing their thinking toward the negative.
你那一刻，你立刻影响了他们，去往更负面的方向。
Oh, that choir today was just, oh, it was out of tune.
你可能就只是简单的说，哦，诗班今天大走音。
Or.Oh, the choir today was really trying hard, weren't they?
但是你也可以另外一个讲，就是哦，今天诗班真是尽了他们的努力。
You see, you hear the difference?
你有听到这两个评语中间的不同吗？
The way you talk, the way you think, influences people, influences attitudes.
我们说的话跟我们的思想都可以影响我们身边的人。
Therefore.We have to measure carefully what comes out of our mouths.
所以我们要仔细地衡量从我们口中所说的话。
Because we all affect either negatively or positively the spirit and attitude within the congregation, within the church, within the community.
因为这会对我们的会众、对我们身边的人、对我们的教会带来正面或是负面的影响。
So the answer to your question is, where do you start? You start with yourself.
所以对这位姐妹的答案就是，我们可以怎么去做，去离开这个文化的受限呢？是我们要从自己开始。
You measure your own negativity, and when someone speaks to you, you turn it to a positive, if at all possible.
所以当即使当别人问我们说负面的话，我们也要用正面的去思考它。
We have a saying in the south southern part of the United States. That was either a mosquito or a fly. You attract more flies with honey.
所以我们在
than you do with something bad that doesn't taste good.
我们在美国的南方有一句名言，就是你用糖会吸引比较多的苍蝇，而不是用那个吃不好，就是吃相不好的食物。
If you want to attract people to your church, you be positive about your church.
如果你想要吸引更多人来你的教会，那我们就要有一个正面的态度。
You talk about how wonderful your preacher is.
我们要讲我们的牧师是多么好的讲者。
And how he feeds you every time he opens his mouth and preaches.
他每一次开口讲道的时候，就是造就人的话语。
And how wonderful all the people are in the church.
我们的教会是有多么好的弟兄姐妹。
How accepting and nurturing and loving everybody is.
这个教会是多么的接纳，这个教会是多么的鼓励，这个教会是多么的团结、相爱。
If everyone who is in this room today started talking positively about the church in an affirming manner all of the time, and every time they heard someone say something negative, they countered it with something positive.Within 6 months, the attitude in this church would measurably increase.
如果今天在位的每一个人从现在开始都用一个正面的方式去鼓励、去激励，然后去分享的话，那我相信在六个月之内，这个教会会有极大的不同。
And on that, I will give you a money back guarantee.
所以这个时候我就会把讲员费退给大家。
讲员
啊，不是讲员费啊，不好意思。他意思是说，就是那个，我是怎么讲？如果没有，如果不，就是怎么讲？不成功退费。
Another question. These are all great.
还有问题吗？
I got him. Whoa. Yes, ma'am.
Follow up the scenario I introduced this morning. I'm thinking, is that only way to raise the potential leader, group leader? The only way that is through the current Sunday school classes. Or is there any possibility because a big congregation that, and many of them maybe already stay in the church for more than decades, and some of them also from Western Christian countries, but because maybe for a long time they cannot find suitable groups, so they disconnect with those groups. So after congregation, they just left. Yeah. And will it be a pity? Maybe among that pool, there are some godly Christians that are mature, and haven't been recognized. Mm-hmm. And then, but things that maybe only in the service is the only opportunity to see them, but we don't know who are they. Is there any experience that to connect with them?
这位姐妹的问题就是说，其实因为他讲的这样子的教会里面会有很多其实是已经从西方的基督教的国家来的，那这样子的话，但是因为没有适当的场合去认识他们，所以也没有办法去建造这样子的主日学。那请问有什么方法可以增加这样的连结，或者是加速这样子的团体的产生，对吧？对吧，姐妹
？How do you find leadership, right? Just how do
我们怎么找领袖呢
？How do you locate leadership within the church, and especially when some of them have kind of backed off?
Yeah, because I'm in international congregation, and so I consume some aspects there, and also experience some aspect like. New aspect they came, and once they could not find the support groups, then they left. That's a pity, But actually, it's a big international congregation, so there are some Western there, just that they haven't formed a group.
Right.
So maybe some of them, they are leaders there, but how to find them? Because things are all disconnect with church activities.
Right. That's always a problem, especially with international churches, because one of the difficulties that we had at KIBC is we didn't have enough small groups. And so people would come, they would not get connected, they would kind of become natural, just what we would call bench warmers. They would come to worship, and they kind of got satisfied just coming to worship. And yet, in churches where they had come from, they had been leaders, been strong leaders, even small group leaders. And so, how do you identify who they are, and how do you bring them into focus within the church and harness them?
所以这个问题，刚这个姐妹讲到这个问题，就是说，那我们怎么样在教会里面找到领袖？或许这些领，因为我们是 因为常常在一个国际性的教会里面，我们常常会有一些外来者，但是他们之前在他们的母会的时候已经是参与服事，已经是领袖了，或者是已经是灵命已经成熟的基督徒了，但是可能因为没有这样子组织的关系呢，他们没有办法找到适合的团队来服事，所以他们常常就会变成那种就进来坐一坐，然后板凳热了然后就走了，这样子是来参加只是来参加崇拜这样子。那牧师说他们在他的在港龙的浸信会的时候也遇到同样的状况，就是说因为常常会有一些外地来的人，但是他们可能在他们的母会已经常常有服事了，但是因为成人主义学的空间还是有限，所以没有办法去有效的去运用这些有恩赐在我们中间在他们中间有恩赐的人。
That's an extremely good question.
这是个好问题。
I wish I knew the answer.
我希望我知道这个答案。
Because it's not easy.
因为这不是个简单的事。
I wish I had a magic wand and say, well, this is the way you do that.
我希望我有一个魔术棒，然后立刻告诉你说，这个就是你的解套方法。
But there is no easy way to do that.
但这不是个简单，这不是一个立刻就有解答的问题。
It will take a long time to build up a small group system within a church.That has not had the experience of doing that over a period of time.
在一个教会里面会花一要设立一个完整全面性的基督的主日学系统，在一个教会里面通光了需要花很多时间，尤其是如果这个教会已经有一段时间没有操练这样的系统的话。
You remember that from my experience at Kowloon International Baptist Church, KIBC.It took me 2 years to start the first two groups, two additional years.
所以大家记得，当我刚到港龙教会的时候，花我2年的时间才设立两个主日学。
It took a lot of praying, a lot of talking to people, a lot of encouragement, and finding out personally, becauseAnnouncements and y'all come and all those kinds of things doesn't work in this situation.
其实我需要花很多时间来建立关系，来认识这些人，因为就算是你喊破喉咙在报告台上面，也没有办法达到这样的果效。
What I eventually had to do was.I would go to someone and I would say, "Have you considered being a leader of a small group?"
So, my subsequent procedure is, I would one-on-one go to face these brothers and sisters and ask them, "Have you considered being a leader of a small group?"
And you don't know how many Moses I talked to.
You won't believe I met many Moses.
Not me, Lord, not me.
大家的答案常常就是哦，不是我，这不是我该做的。
But you can't start a small group with one leader, either.
但是一个小组的形成不可以只有一个领袖。
So once I found someone who would say yes, I'll do it if you can, you know, give me a group. Well, then we had to work together to find 3 or 4 or 5 people who would be willing to start a new group.
因为当我就算当我们找到有一位他愿意来当一个领袖的时候，我们还是需要再找大概4到5个人愿意一起来加入这样的小组。
But once the process begins, once you started one, it's easier to start two. Once you started two, it's easier to start four.
当你开始这样的流程的时候，当你成功的完成一个这样子的团队的时候。开始第二个就更简单了，有两个之后开始4个就够，又更简单了。
Because God is a multiplying God, not an adding God.
因为上帝是一个倍增的神。
So when we started off with 5 classes and now we have 13 classes, hopefully when we get the space and the difficulty in our culture isIt's difficult to start small groups because nobody wants to have them in their home. And our facilities are filled up, so we have groups on Thursday night, we have groups on Wednesday night, we have groups on Friday night, but we still need more space.
而当我们从五个小组增加到十三个小组，那我们要更往前走的时候，当然对于港龙教会来说，他们的一个比较大受限的地方就是他们的空间不够，因为有一些人可能还不太愿意开放他们的家来办这个小组，所以他们在周间里面可能礼拜三、礼拜四、礼拜五晚上都有小组，但是这样子的小组的数量还是不够。
The only way I can answer your question is that you have to be intentional about it. It won't happen on its own. It won't just happen. You have to lay the groundwork. You have to water the plants, and you have to fertilize, and you have to work at it. And eventually, after you have done your work, then God will start blessing that.
所以对于这位姐妹的问题，我们要怎么样找到对的人跟对的领袖呢？这个答案就只是我们需要刻意的去找，我们需要刻意的松土，需要刻意的灌溉，需要刻意的施肥。当我们做好这一些刻意的准备工作的时候，那在神的时间里面，他就会动工。
But God could use any person in this room.
但是上帝可以使用我们在座的任何一位。
Who is called and start another small group.
如果我们愿意接受上帝的呼召，然后开始一个小组的话。
Two or three or four of you could get together and start a small group.
甚至在座的我们弟兄姐妹，三四个人可以聚在一起，这就是一个小组的开始。
Scheduling, of course, is going to be a problem.
当然对于这个排时刻来讲是一个比较大的挑战。
So you have to start praying about where, when, and how.
所以在准备小组的时候，我们要祷告这个它的时间，然后它的地点，然后它怎么样才能开始。
Okay.
好吗？
Does that help? Another question.
对不起，我可不可以再请问刚也还没有讲完的有个疑问哈，那个就是刚刚说，我们要先建立关系有没有哈，然后再传福音跟他建立友谊啊。那有时候我会想就是说，这个人跟他认识了哈，就有机会赶快传福音给他，一边传福音一边跟他建立关系啊。那有时候像有一些真的要传福音给他，结果没有的时候。结果有些发生意外就去世了，你连传福音的机会都没有啊！所以我是说，跟他，假如说有认识，跟他有建立彼此，平常就在预备了哈，一有机会先传，一边传一边跟他建立关系，是不是也可以这样？
好
，OK， 好，这样有没有要注意什么事的？
是，
谢谢。
Okay, so on the topic of evangelistic friendship, sometimes our life may be unexpectedly long or short. So if we have to establish a friendship before we actually share the gospel, would it be, maybe sometimes it could be too late. So would it be, how do we get the balance?
姊妹，对不起，还有你帮我翻译一下说，保罗不是说得死不得死都要传福音。
Oh, because Paul says that good times and bad times we should preach the gospel.
Yes, good times and bad times we should preach the gospel. The question I would have to you is, if you follow God's leadership, then He will tell you when it's time to express the gospel to the person that you're with.
所以姐妹，这个答案就是，如果我们真的心在神里面的话，上帝的灵会告诉我们什么是一个对的时刻来分享这个福音，
就可以了。
对。
As I talked about earlier, when we practice the presence of God in our lives, and we're always concerned about people, and whenever we meet a person, we say, God, what should I say to this person?He will lead us and guide us in saying what we, what is most appropriate for that particular person. The thing we have to remember is that we are not the only people God is using in this world.
Okay.
There are other people.
刚刚忘记了，没有，意思就是说，就好像是刚刚牧师一开始在讲，就是我们要操练跟神的同在。当我们常常我们的心常常跟神同在，那我们也常常的对身边的人表示关心。当我们每一次看到一位朋友，我们就发自内心的问说：“神啊，我今天该为这个人，该跟这个人说什么？”那这个时候，我们就能够知道上帝对这个人的心意。我们也可以同时为这个人祷告，因为我们要记得，就是上帝不是只有使用我一个人而已，他是使用很多，他是使用我们每一个人。
Remember in 1 Corinthians, first chapter, Paul is talking about Peter and Apollos.And Paul, how one had watered and one had did this and one had did that, but God gave the increase.
就是
What we need to realize is that this person may not be the first time that this person has heard the gospel. We may be the third time when we present the gospel to them and they accept it. God is in the world working.Around us and through other people as well. And so some of us, some evangelists are harvesters and some are planters, some are waterers. And what we need to do is do the job that God has called us to do.
So this place is.因为上帝对一个人的救赎不是来自于单单来自于另外一个人，而是像保罗他在哥林多前书第一章里面讲的，就是我栽种了，亚波罗浇灌了，但是是上帝让他成长。所以这个意思就是告诉我们说，对于我们来说，我们对于身边弟兄姐妹生命的影响，我们可能有一些只是那个播土的，有一些只是那个施肥的，但是最后是上帝让他成长。
If God has given you the gift of evangelism and called you to be an evangelist, and you don't do that, then you're not doing what God wants you to do.
如果你今天很清楚上帝给你传福音的恩赐，但是你却不去传福音，那你就是没有做到上帝呼召你去做的事工。
But God does not call all of us to be evangelists.
但是上帝并没有叫我们所有的人都成为就是都有传福音的恩赐。
But He does call us to all to be evangelistic.
但是他确实有跟我们说，我们每一个人都要分享福音。
And there are many ways to be evangelistic.
当然，分享福音的方式有很多种。
I do not have the gift of evangelism. I have won many people. I have not won many people to the Lord. I have led many people to the Lord. But I was part of a process. I've had people walk into my office and say, Phil, I'm ready to be a Christian. And all I had to do was say,Repeat after me.
就是牧师这边他并没有传他不是他没有宣教的恩赐，但是他却已经带领很多人信主。但是牧师他的角色在这样子的转化的过程当中，他就是其中的一关。然后比如说有一些时候就有一些人直接就到他的办公室门口说。牧师，我已经准备好变基督徒了。牧师所需要做的事，就只是说，哦，那你就跟着我的祷告一起念。
But I'm not, I'm not an evangelist. Somebody else had done the work. All I did was bring them in.
所以可能有别人已经做了前面的松土跟做工的部分，但是牧师要做的就只是把他们带到神的面前来。
On the other hand, I have.Built friendships with people and presented them the gospel, and they said, "No, no, I'm not ready to do that."
但是在另外一方面，或许牧师也认识了很多人，他们一开始不是基督徒，或是牧师跟他们讨论福音的时候，他们也都说，哦，我还没准备好。
And weeks or years or months later, someone else has talked to them, and they said, "Oh, okay, I'll do that."
但是几个星期、几个月，或是几年、几十年以后，或许另外一个人在另外一个时机里面跟这些人再次的传福音，他们就欣然的接受了。
Did I have any responsibility in that? Of course I do. You know, every time they were in a church service and heard the preach, there was responsibility. God was working in all of those people in all of those ways.To water the ground and to give the fertilizer. One day, God gave the increase.
因为上帝透过各种管道、不同的方式来浇灌，来动工，直到那时机到了，上帝就让他做。
Another question.
还有问题吗
？Oh, great question.We're going to have to take a break.
I got a question.
Nick,
you want coffee? McDonald's will come up. What do you want? Small, medium, large.
Small.
Small, McDonald's, okay?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Question I just need your caffeine.
Take a break.
Cream or sugar?
A person who is able to motivate other people to learn.
但是不幸的是，当一个知识的传授者，往往都比当一个鼓励学习的鼓励者来的简单。
One of the things we think is effective teaching is the leader always talking.
我们常常会觉得最有效的一种学习的方式，就是当你的老师一直讲。
We fail to remember that.People remember what they say more effectively than they remember what we say as teachers.
但是我们常常忘记，学生学最快的方式不是老师说了什么，而是他们自己说了什么。
People tend to remember what they see and hear better than what they just hear.
如果一个学生可以又看到又听到的话，比他们只是听到来的。容易记忆的多。
So the task of a teacher is to help the learner to want to learn more.
所以一个老师的功用是去帮助学习者有想学习更多的渴望。
There are basic ingredients to lesson preparation. There are four that I have listed.
一个好的课程预备有四个要素。
The first one is personal spiritual preparation.
第一个是个人的属灵预备。
Now this is very important.
这是很重要的要素。
To me, it's probably the most important.
对我来说，可能是最重要的要素。
As the person who is the leader.Of the class, when I read the scripture that I'm going to be teaching, I need to be prepared for it to speak to me first.
当我在准备一个课程的时候，最重要的是这个课程的内容先跟我自己说话。
The tendency is for me to think of my Sunday school class or my small group, read the passage of scripture and say, "Oh,Jenny needs to hear this. Frank needs to hear this. Jim needs to hear this.
但是当我们常常在备课的时候，我们看到这个教材，我们往往第一个会想先说的就是哦，这段经额最适合某某某了。那段经额一定要让谁谁谁知道，还有谁谁谁这个经额一定要提醒他。
But the first thing we need to do when we read that passage of scripture is say, what do I need to hear out of this passage of scripture?
但是当我们在备课的时候，当我们在读经的时候，我们第一个要想的是我能够从这个经文上获得什么。
The next thing we need to do is have time for preparation.
第二件事我们需要的就是我们需要有准备的时间。
How many of you have ever started preparing a lesson for class on Saturday night when you were going to teach on Sunday morning?
我们有多少人，比如说礼拜天要教课，礼拜六晚上才开始准备的
？Confession time.
My daughter Sunday morning.
Oh my. Yeah. How many of you have never prepared?
Huh? 还有没有准备备课的人吗?
When does preparation start?
当这样子的备课开始的时候,
ideally,
理想上,
the first thing you need to do on Sunday night is you need to read the scripture for the coming Sunday.
其实最理想的方式就是在下一个主日来临之前的前一个主日晚上, 你就应该要开始准备下一个主日的课程了。And
you ask the question for the first one or two days, what is God saying to Phil?
所以你在接下来的两天或者是这个星期的第一天跟第二天的时候, 你问自己这段经文对于你自己本身是有什么样的意义?
Now the reason I say this is because there are five things there that I have listed among many others that are the reasons for you to begin early.
我在下面有写五个原因，这五个原因是告诉你为什么你应该要及早预备。
It lowers your stress level.
第一个就是它会让你没有那么大的压力。
Which means your heart level will be lower, which means you will live longer in life.
第一件事情就是呢，因为你没有那么多压力，所以你心脏承受压力没有那么大，所以呢，你的心脏状况比较好，你也可以比较长寿。
You will have adequate time to pray about this class.
其中你有足够的时间可以来祷告，为这个课程祷告。
And if you read the scripture early, you can start formulating questions that you have about the scripture so that you can do the proper research to answer those questions for yourself.
第三个原因是你有足够的时间来找跟这个经文相关的其他资料。
Now remember, just because you have that question doesn't mean somebody else has that question.
但是请记得，你有这个疑问，并不代表你的小组员也有同样的疑问。
So it may have nothing to do with your teaching, but you need to know that as your own background.
所以这可能 这些找到的资源可能最后跟你课程的内容没有一定的关联，但是为了让你自己学习，这是一个很好的过程。The
next thing is it gives you adequate time to ponder.
第四个原因是它给你足够的时间来思考。And
you ponder what God wants you to teach about this lesson.
你可以思考上帝究竟要你去教导一个什么样的课程。
Does ponder translate real well into Chinese?
思考, yes, sir.
Okay, because I love that word, to ponder. You dwell on it. It kind of rolls around in your mind and you think about it and you allow, and you think about it and you say, God, what is it that you want me to come out of? When that person walks out of my Sunday school class, what is it that you want me to have introduced them to or giving them information about or confronted them in their lives about? What is in the scripture that needs to be spoken to my friends?
牧师很喜欢ponder这个字, ponder 在中文可以是思考、思索，甚至有点探索的意思，就是你是反复的去思想这一个主题。那当我们有足够的时间在一个星期中去思考我们课程中的经文的时候，我们就可以去反复的想， 上帝到底要我们在这样子的课程中带给我们组员的讯息是什么，或者是说，当这个组员他领受了这个课程，他离开的时候，我们希望他带走的，这个收获是什么？
See, once you've determined what it is that you want the person to walk out of the class with, then it's time for you to start building your lesson plan.
所以呢，当我们能够
想到说我们从这个经文中可以领受到的东西的时候，我们这个时候再来准备课程。
Only after you know what you need to accomplish can you come up with an introduction.
直到我们知道我们在这个课程中想要带出来的主题，我们才有办法去想它的开头该是怎么带。
Can you come up with a content?
我们才能想它的主旨是什么。
And come up with the application.
我们才能想它的应用是什么。
That comes at the end of the lesson.
那当然，这个应用是在课程最后的时候提出来的。
We use different terminology in all of these areas. My wife with university students and teenagers uses the words connect and content and collide, I think. I'm not sure.
当然像不一样的年龄层会用不一样的字。基本上重点就是先有一个连结，然后再有一个主题，最后是有一个应用。
But every lesson needs to have those three points.
但是每一个课程都应该需要有三个主题，第一个三个部分，第一个就是连结。
You need an introduction that connects with the people so that they will understand why we're studying this passage of scripture.
我们需要一开始有一个前言，一个引言，一个引导，所以我们可以让组员们能够去跟这样子的主题有所连结。
The second thing you need to do is you need to present them with the truth of the gospel, the truth of the content of that particular passage of scripture.
课程的第二部分就是我们需要去去铺陈这个事，这个真实，这个圣经中教导我们的道理。
And the last thing is you need to apply it.
最后一部分就是应用。
When the you need to answer the question at the very end, so what?
在我们课程的最后，我们要问自己一个问题：所以呢
？What is this?What does this passage of scripture mean to me, to my class, today in the world as we walk out of that door? What difference should it make?
所以这段经文，这个主题对我，对我的组员，对我走出这个教室大门要面对的世界是有什么应用呢？是可以有什么冲击呢？
Now, there are many different tools that you will need to use during the preparation time. Use various translations for yourself. Use commentaries. You can use dictionaries. You can use Bible atlases. Any number of different things, and I have those listed.
当然工具也非常的重要，除了圣经以外，我们可以用不同的译本，我们可以用圣经字典，我们可以有圣经的注意，我们也可以有其他的著作来帮助我们。
The great thing about the world today is we have the internet.
当然还有我们有一个非常强大的工具，那就是网路。
And so many of these resources are readily available on the internet.
这中间有很多的资源直接在网路上面就可以取得。
I assume they're as available in Chinese as they are in other languages.
我相信他们在中文的资源也是非常的丰富的。
When I left the United States, I had a wonderful office that probably had as many books in it as we have over here on this wall.
在我离开美国的时候呢，我有一个非常非常好的。这个办公室，办公室里面的藏书大概就跟这面墙一样多。
I put all those books in storage and put them in boxes and put it in storage and left them in the United States.
我将这些书全部都把它放在箱子里面，然后把它们留在美国。
And I got here and I said, Oh my goodness, what am I going to do without my books?
那当我来到了香港的时候，我就想说，天哪，没有这些书，我该怎么办？
An old man like me discovered the internet.
然后我这个老人呢，就找到了网路。
And so I do all of my research now on the internet.
所以我现在利用网络来做我大部分的资源的搜寻。
Don't tell me you can't teach an old dog new tricks.
不要告诉我老狗学不了新技巧。
There are many ways. Basically, in most Sunday school classes, there are two teaching techniques that we use.
基本上在大部分的主日学里面，我们有两种教学的方式。
That is lecture.
第一个是演讲式的。
And group discussion.
第二个是讨论式的。
There are great advantages to lecture.
当然，演讲可以有非常多的优点。
If you have a large amount of information to give at a particular time, the best way to do that is to tell them.
如果你一次想要传达大量的讯息的话，最好的方式就是透过演讲。
And if you're a great speaker like I am, you can give them all kinds of enthusiastic motivation and go, go, go kinds of stuff.
如果你是像牧师一样优秀的讲者的话，那你也可以在演讲的时候注入很多的热情，然后很多的鼓励。
Except you get tired doing that.
当然，在演讲的过程中也是非常的疲惫的。
And the teacher has the maximum control over the class.
在演讲的方式中，老师对于整个课堂的掌握是最好的。
But the emphasis is on listening.
但是这个他着重的是在聆听。
And if people are not good listeners,
而当你的组员不是透过聆听来学习的话，
it's a disadvantage.
那就可能变成一种劣势了。
And if you go for over 15, it says 20 minutes, I think, in my thing, but if you go for over 15 minutes without some kind of a break or something, you can tell by the look in their face, their eyes just kind of go.
然后一个演讲如果超过了50分钟的话，那你就会看到你的听众的眼睛大概已经开始涣散了。
And when they do that, it's time to do the hokey pokey.
当大家涣散的时候，可能你就要请他站起来一起跳 hokey pokey 舞。